Once upon a time, there's an old widow and her beautiful daughter named Darmi in a village in West Kalimantan, Indonesia. They lived in a simple house located at the end of the village. Since Darmi's father died, their life became difficult because the father did not leave any inheritance to fulfill the lives of Darmi and her mother. To make things worse, the mother works in other people's rice fields or other fields as a hired laborer. While Darmi grew into a spoiled girl, whatever she asks for, it must be granted. Besides being spoiled, Darmi is also a lazy girl. Darmi often walks around her village without a clear purpose. She only spending time dresses up and admires her beauty. She only shows off her beautiful face and does not want to help her mother earn money in the fields. Every time her mother invited her to work in the fields or just cleaning the house, Darmi always refused.
"Darmi, my daughter, come help me clean our house, and after that let's go to the rice fields."
"No way. I don't want to clean the house. I'll get mud on my nails and skin and it will damage them."
"Don't you feel sorry for me, my daughter?"
"No. Because you're old, you're the only one who's supposed to work in the fields, not me. Besides, there's no way any man would be interested in your dull, wrinkled face."
Hearing Darmi's answer, the mother was speechless. Heartbroken, she cleaned up their messy house and then she left to the rice fields for work. And Darmi still stayed at home while dressing herself up. After the mother returned from the fields, Darmi asked for the wage money her mother earned to buy beauty tools.
"Where is that rice field's money, mother?"
"No, my daughter. That money is to buy our needs for today."
"But my cosmetics have run out. I have to buy new ones."
"You are indeed an ignorant child. You always know how to spend money, but you just don't want to work."
However, despite being upset and angry, the mother still gave Darmi her wage money. This continued until the next day. Darmi asked her mother for more money to buy her other beauty tools. This situation always happens almost every day. And one day, the mother was going to the market, and Darmi asked to buy a beauty tool. However,
"Then, let's go with me to the market."
"I don't want to go to the market with you, Mom."
"But, I don't know what beauty tools you're talking about, honey."
"I want to go to the market, but on the condition that you walk behind me."
"What's wrong with me walking beside you?"
"I'm ashamed of the villagers if I walk side by side with you."
"Why should I be ashamed, my daughter? Am I not your biological parent?"
"You should look in the mirror. Look at that wrinkled face and those dirty clothes. I'm ashamed to have such ugly and messy parents."
Although it was very sad for her to hear this, the mother agreed to her daughter's request. After that, they went to the market together. Darmi walked in front, while her mother followed behind.
Although they were both mother and daughter, their appearance was completely different, as if there was no family relationship. On the way, Darmi met her friend who lived in another village.
"Darmi, where are you going?"
"To the market."
"Then, who is that person behind you? Is she your mother?"
"Absolutely not. She is my maid." As if struck by lightning, the mother heard her daughter's words. But she remained silent while holding back her tears. After that, the two continued their journey to the market. Not long after, they met someone again.
"Hey, Darmi. Where are you going?"
"To the market."
"Who's that behind you?"
"He's my maid." Darmi's answer certainly made her mother even more heartbroken and painful. However, the mother was still strong enough to endure her sadness. That's how it kept happening on the way to the market. Finally, the mother stopped and sat down on the side of the road.
"Mom, why did you stop?"
Several times Darmi asked, but her mother remained silent, not answering her questions. A moment later, Darmi saw her mother's mouth speaking softly while raising both of her hands up.
"Mom, what are you doing?"
"Oh Lord, my God. Forgive me, your weak servant. I can no longer face the attitude of my disobedient daughter. Give her the punishment she deserves.
A few moments later, the sky suddenly became cloudy. Lightning flashed and the sound of thunder was ear-shattering. It was raining heavily. Then turns out, Darmi's feet became hard and changing into stone. Darmi began to panic.
Mother! Mother! What happened to my leg?
I'm sorry, Mom. I'm sorry. I won't do it again.
However, just like what people said, it's no use crying over split milk. It's all already happened and it can no longer be avoided. Slowly but sure, Darmi's entire body turned to stone. The change occurred from the feet, body, to the head.
Not long after, the weather returned to light as before. But Darmi's entire body had turned into stone. They then placed somewhere in the forest. The local people named the stone Badu Menangis, or the Crying Stone.